Hi Siddhis, welcome to another session of Social Science. In this session, we are going to start our Politics Chapter 1, Indian Constitution. I hope you all are familiar with the word Constitution. From 6th standard onwards, you are hearing the word and you are learning the word, the meaning of the Constitution. So what is meant by Constitution? The Constitution is the supreme law of India. It is a document which describes the rights and duties of its citizens and the way in which it is governed. The Indian Constitution is the longest in the world. It took around 2 years, 11 months and 17 days for the assembly to finish writing the entire Constitution, and that too handwritten. The Constitution of India guarantees certain basic rights that are essential to the well-being of every citizen. These are known as fundamental rights. The Indian Constitution is unique in its features, and also many of its features have been borrowed from various other countries like United States of America, France, Ireland, Australia, Japan and Canada. So there will be a question in your mind. That is, why do we need a constitution? So why do we need a constitution? Let's understand the answer of this question through the video.
Why do you think the umpire has given the free hit for the batsman? Yes, the bowler has crossed the crease completely, which is considered as no ball. You all know the rules of cricket. Similarly, in football, the player should not touch the ball with his hand. In every game, we have some rules, and these rules help define the game and helps us distinguish one game from another. Do we have such rules in our society? Yes, like these games, a society also has constitutive rules that make it what it is and differentiate it from other kinds of societies. In large societies in which different communities of people live together, these rules are formulated through consensus, and in modern countries, this consensus is usually available in written form. A written document in which we find such rules is called a constitution. Why do you think we need a constitution? The constitution serves several purposes. Let us look at them one by one. Constitution lays out certain ideals that form the basis of the kind of country that we as citizens aspire to live in. A constitution helps serve as a set of rules and principles that the entire population in a country can agree upon. Let us understand it with an example of our neighboring country, Nepal. The country of Nepal has witnessed several people's struggles for democracy. There was a people's struggle in 1990 that established democracy. But the constitution rested the final authority with the king. After a people's movement for a long time in 2006, they finally succeeded in putting an end to the powers of the king. They had to write a new constitution to establish Nepal as a democracy.
I hope you all have understood the concept. And today, what all topics we covered? Meaning of the constitution. Why do we need a constitution? One more concept is there in this chapter, that is about features of Indian constitution that we will be discussing in another session. Thank you.